I've lived in Greenbelt, lived 25 years. I had a two-bedroom flat. It wasn't a very nice place to live in. Well, I got up one morning and I wasn't feeling very well, and I sneezed, and one of my eyes seemed to pop, and then I couldn't see anything out of it. So I went to my doctor and he took me to a specialist, and he told me I was blind in the right eye. Well, when I go shopping, as you know, I can't go by myself, so I've got two very good friends. Either one of them will come and take me shopping. Sue normally does, and Lucy does sometimes. And it's a great help to me, because I can't even see the things on the shelves or what they are to go shopping by myself. I couldn't walk that far by myself anyway, so. They have a note for me with what I've got to get, and they get it for me, so that I don't have to go up and down the hallways looking for stuff which I wouldn't be able to find anyway. And the bus service is very bad. They do not wait for you to sit down before the bus takes off. And therefore you tumble before you can get a seat. And the bus drivers are very rude indeed. They don't wait for elderly people to get on the bus properly, which they have to, which they don't. And that is a very bad thing. Now, I had a daughter, and at five, I was told she was blind, or partially blind in one eye and not the other. Anyway, the ambulance took me to the hospital, and I didn't have money, and I had to walk all the way back home to Ashcroft. But she was in hospital for about 3 or 4 weeks, and because I was on a pension, I couldn't afford to keep going in and out, so I'd walk up there and walk back again. It took me about an hour and a half to get to Liverpool Casualty, and when I come back home, it was another hour and a half walk before I could get back home. When I moved to Green Valley, my husband was an alcoholic, and the girl in the next flat to me, her husband was in jail, and he spent half the night over there before he came home. And then she was supposed to be a friend of mine, so she moved to a house, and I went down to the house, talked to her because my husband didn't come home, and I found them in bed together. So then I made arrangements for a divorce. And I got divorced straight away, and they gave it to me very easily. And I've never spoken to the girl since, because she's not a friend of mine. I used to take my daughter shopping down to Miller. There was no footpaths, and do the shopping and have to walk back again with no footpaths. Used to walk on the road, because she was in a pram. And that was very hard, because I had to carry my groceries as well as the pram with the baby in it. I'm 57, and I'll be 58 in November of this year.